and was found something. It looked like a single black hair. It was sent to Chris Thompson of Fiber Vision, an international manufacturer of synthetic fibers, using infrared analysis as well as light microscopy. Thompson determined the fiber had several unusual qualities.
So kind of limits the number of applications or products that it can go into.
The fiber's length, 4 inches, was also uncommon.
The length was consistent with something you might find in a man.
And that wasn't all the tape lifts recovered from inside the street's truck. Trace elements of gunshot residue were also found. This residue is almost impossible to completely clean up.
This trace minute evidence is more common than most people realize.
The evidence was compelling. The killer was almost certainly driving the Stroop family truck the evening of the murder. But who was behind the wheel? Who handled the gun? Who wore the wig?
We were not able to come up with a single piece of direct evidence concerning the guilt of anyone in this case.
A weak fiber and gunshot residue told detectives that Heather Struve's killer was most likely driving the Struve family truck. Joanna Hayes, Heather's mother-in-law, admitted driving that truck.
Thank you.
sure the baby was secure in his car seat, she was sure. No one knows what they said to each other, but Joanna got it. The century executed Heather in Dawn. She drove 64 miles away, icily, in an attempt to create power. But police proved that she could have made the drive in plenty of time. Joanna didn't realize she left a single wind fiber and did not let it be behind. Clear proof that whoever drove the truck was a killer. Where Joanna got rid of the 38-year-old wig, no one knows. In the end, the most damning evidence came from her son. Down to a single